between 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. In fact, we have some various ministers, big ministers from central government ministers and our state ministers are participating in that. Dr. Jitendra Singh, Union Minister for State from the Prime Minister's office, Sri P.P. Chowdhury, Union Minister of State for Law and Justice, Mr. Anant Kumar Hegde, Union Minister for State for Skill Development and Entrepreneurs, Sri Pon Radhakrishnan, Union Minister for State for Finance, along with our Deputy Prime Minister, Chief Minister, Sri O. Poneerselvam, will be the chief guest for this meeting. We are associating ourselves with Bharat Nithi, which is a public policy advocacy organization with more than 30 chapters in various cities and towns across India, consisting of political parties, policy makers, administrators, academics, researchers, senior journalists, activities, etc., to spread the information on various public policy matters and initiative discussions and debates on aspects related to various public policies from time to time. In fact, this has initiated us to tag us along with Bharat Nithi because we would like to initiate on the entire problems of the Southern film industry and how to take it forward further more than what we have been achieving so far. We would like to concentrate on the problems of the regional cinemas and find the solutions too. There are more than about 30 speakers which we are getting it from Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam and Kannada film industry, and they'll speak on various problems like GST, online piracy, the expansion of market and also the expansion of overseas market for all the regional films. All the organizations in South India of the South Indian film industry will be attending the same, and we seek the cooperation of the press and media to support us for the first, which is being this conclave being held for the first time in South India. The most important aspect of this conference is we'll be preparing a white paper on the entire conclave, and this will be presented to our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji through our Information Broadcasting Minister Mrs. Smita Irani. And Bharat Nithi is paving the way for removing the obstacles which is being faced by the regional film industry. Tamil mudan muriyaga Tennindiyavil oru film industry sarvaga oru maabarum conclave adhaadu periya conference nadaipera ulladhu ena engalukku நாங்கள் சேர்ந்து காமன் ப்ராப்ளம் அப்படின்னு நான் பார்க்க போனால் நாங்கள் நாலு லாங்குவேஜுக்கும் ஆன்லைன் பைரசி நம்பர் ஒன், தென் அவங்க 6000 பிரிண்ட் 8000 பிரிண்ட் போடுறாங்க, அவங்களுக்கு அதை தவிர்த்து அவங்க கிட்டத்தட்ட 168 கண்ட்ரிஸ் இருக்குதுல, 104 கண்ட்ரிஸ் அவங்களால ஸ்க்ரீன் பண்ண முடிகிறது, 25-30 கண்ட்ரியில் தமிழ் படங்களை வெளியிட முடிகிறது. ஆனால் தெலுங்குன்னு பார்க்க போனால் ஹீ இஸ் ரெப்ரசன்டிங் தி பாரத் நிதி. He'll also speak a few words. There is
regarding to this particular conference has been discussed by our L. Suresh ji here already. I wish to introduce to you a few aspects about Bharat Nithi, because many of you may be having, you have heard the name Bharat Nithi, but would be liking to know what exactly Bharat Nithi does. So as he has mentioned, Bharat Nithi is a public policy advocacy organization. It is headquartered in New Delhi and it operates through its various chapters across 30 important cities and towns of India. We basically deal with public policy matters. There are various issues related to public policy from different industries to different sections of society. It may be from agriculture industry to banking sector to film industry to defense industry. So Bharat Nithi tries to engage and interact with various stakeholders of various industries, come up with suggestions, come up with ideas, and we try to engage the policy makers, whether it may be political leaders, they may be member of parliaments, they may be ministers in the central government and state governments. we successfully engage with them, interact with them, and come up with solutions for various challenges faced by several industries, several sections, and try to take forward the agenda of the nation's development. This time, we had been focusing on various similar issues and similar industries earlier. We have conducted more than 100-150 conferences across India in the past 2-3 years. We have dealt with a large, wide range of issues and subjects, wide range of industries. This is for the first time Bharat Niti is engaging in policy making process related to the film industry, the entertainment industry. As you all know, the entertainment industry is one of the largest growing sectors, which can also act as a soft power for India abroad or in the global markets. So we see a huge potential from the policy perspective as a soft power. The Indian entertainment industry can grow. One day it will become the global leader, leading all entertainment industries in the world. So with that vision, which has been kept forward by our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji also, we are trying to deal with the stakeholders of this industry, and the most important stakeholders are the people from the industry, which are in front of you, the people from film industry, people from TV industry. So we have to deal with them, we have to engage with them. We need ideas, we need inputs. And with that, as he has rightly said, we'll be coming up with some white paper, a similar format, something will be produced. And we'll try to engage with the central government and the state governments to address the key issues and challenges faced by the industry, finding solutions and finding new ideas to take or expand the industry globally. So this is the agenda of the conference from the Bharat Niti perspective.
That 100 years of Indian cinema sonnadu, 100 years of Indian cinema panna edam Tamil Nadu, Chennai. 50 years of Indian cinema, which was done on December 3rd, 1981, that was also done at Chennai. 75 years of Indian cinema, that also was done in Chennai, and it was conducted by South Indian Film Chamber of Commerce. And last but not the least, this 100 years of Indian cinema also was conducted by South Indian Film Chamber of Commerce in Chennai. In fact, South Indian Film Chamber of Commerce have been pioneers in the film industry, supporting the film industry. And today, we have got an opportunity where someone has come forward to hold the hand with us. The film industry, we are facing a lot of issues. And in this stage, we have got someone to come and say, come, let us join, let us fight for your rights, let us clearly explain to the government what are your issues. You know, at present, we got number of issues. Until ipo neenga irukkireenga, press is there. Until you are there, we are able to go through the press, we are able to, with through the media, to the public. And we can go to the government, but there is one more person you require. You need a person to clearly explain the issues to the government. So this is the place where Bharat Niti comes. In fact, this organization has been doing a lot of help. They have been supporting all the industries, and this is the first time they have come forward to support the entertainment. In fact, the entertainment industry only from the four languages, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam. ஒரு சின்ன ஒரு சைக்காலஜிக்கல் ப்ராப்ளம் ஐ ஹவ் டு டெல் யூ பீயிங் தமிழ் தமிழ் தெலுங்கு கன்னடா மலையாளம்னா நீங்கள் யூ ஜஸ்ட் லுக் அரவுண்ட் வி ஆர் லைக் அன் ஐலண்டுங்க வி ஆர் சிட்டிங் ஹியர் டவுன் என்னென்னா தமிழ் படம் ஆந்திரா கர்நாடகா கேரளாவில் ஓடும் தெலுங்கு படம் இந்த திருப்பி இந்த ரெண்டு மூணு பிரதேசத்தில் ஓடும் கர்நாடகா வேறு எங்கே ஓடுறது இல்லை வி ஹாவ் டு ஹெல்ப் டோன்ட் குட் ஹெல்ப் அஸ் தட் இஸ் வேர் வி ஆர் ட்ரைங் டு ஆர்கனைஸ் திஸ் We should find newer avenues, newer markets. This is where we want the government to come and help us. For that, we are asking Bharat Niti to come and, you know, find out, sit and, you know, they have created this small conclave where they have invited union ministers to come and listen to our problems. Until summer, nama kolandha aluda appa amma thirumbi paakanum appa amma kondu varu vela da avanga pannirukanga. They have brought the union ministers here. They have Union ministers are going to patiently listen to our problems. Simple, as I said, then piracy. Piracy, na ipo nariya namakku theriyum, Tamil rockers, ivunga, avunga, ivunga, ella. They have to, all the, you know, mobile carriers have to take it down. They don't take it down. This is where we want the government help to inform every carrier gap between the film industry and the government. And in fact, there's a lot of issues.
Industry can tide over all the problems, solve all the issues. This is our main idea.
Problem to solve
Tamil, global at many times. There is something, the main concept is going global. Market looking at, monetize those markets, how to cash in on those markets is what we are looking at. South Indian Film Chamber of Commerce. South Indian Film Chamber of Commerce is the Appa Amma. Then India Vartaka Sabai. India used to be here, Bengal used to be here.
We have called members from all the associations, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam. We have called everyone there. We are having discussions there.
Film industry in our bedroom, bankers, all managing.
There are a lot of problems in Telugu. Telugu lo pesalama? Vaalu Tamil Nadu lo release avalante meeku cheppinatuga local body tax LBT ani betti chepparu. దానికి 15% ఎక్స్ట్రా ఇప్పుడు తమిళనాడులో పే చేయాల్సి వస్తూ ఉంది. నో వేర్ ఇన్ ఇండియా ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ దేర్. అందుకనే ఓ పన్నీర్ సెల్వం గారి దగ్గర మా కోరిక చెప్పి అదర్ లాంగ్వేజ్ సినిమాలు ఎల్బీటీ లేకుండా రిలీజ్ చేయమని చెప్పి అదర్ లాంగ్వేజ్ సినిమాలను ఇక్కడ ఎంకరేజ్ చేయమని చెప్పి చెప్తున్నాం సార్. మీరు చెప్పినట్టు కర్ణాటకలో తమిళ సినిమాలు రిలీజ్ అవ్వట్లేదు అన్నారు. రిలీజ్ అవుతున్నాయి. అన్ని తమిళ సినిమాలు కర్ణాటకలో రిలీజ్ అవుతున్నాయి, ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్లో రిలీజ్ అవుతున్నాయి. పర్టికులర్గా ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ అయితే తమిళ ఫిలింకి ఒక టెరిటరీ లాగా, తమిళ ప్రొడ్యూసర్స్కి అదొక టెరిటరీ లాగా అండర్ ప్రొడక్షన్లోనే సినిమాలు ఏరియా తెలుగు ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ తెలుగు రైట్స్ అని కొంటున్నారు. మంచి మార్కెట్ అవుతుంది తమిళ సినిమాలకి. ఆంధ్రప్రదేశ్ అండ్ తెలంగాణలో మంచి మార్కెట్ ఉంది. సో ఇంకొకటి ఏంటంటే మన ప్రధానమంత్రి గారు మోడీ గారి స్లోగన్ను మేక్ ఇన్ ఇండియా స్లోగన్, మేక్ ఇన్ ఇండియా స్లోగన్ అని చెప్పి చెప్తున్నాం. నిర్మాతలకైనా మాకు సింగిల్ విండో పర్మిషన్స్ రావట్లేదు, ఛార్జెస్ అబ్నార్మల్ ఛార్జెస్, ఫారిన్ కంట్రీస్లో షూటింగ్కి వెళ్తే ఫ్రీ లొకేషన్స్ ఇస్తున్నారు, ఇండియాలో మాత్రం పర్మిషన్స్ వచ్చేదే కష్టం, వచ్చినా ఛార్జెస్ ప్రొడ్యూసర్లు భరించలేనంత ఛార్జెస్, అబ్నార్మల్ ఛార్జెస్ జరుగుతున్నాయి. అదొకటి ఈ రిక్వెస్ట్ పెట్టాలని ఈ మీటింగ్లో అనుకున్నాం. అలాగే మోడీ గారు ఇంకొక స్లోగన్ ఏంటంటే చైనాతో కాంపీట్ చేసి నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ థియేటర్స్ స్క్రీన్స్ పెంచాలని. చైనాలో 35,000 స్క్రీన్స్ ఉన్నాయి, ఇండియాలో ఓన్లీ 9,000 స్క్రీన్స్ ఉన్నాయి, ఈ నెంబర్ పెంచాలని చెప్పి మోడీ గారి ఆశ. అది కూడా ప్రయత్నం చేయాలంటే మాకు గవర్నమెంట్ నుంచి ఫుల్ సపోర్ట్ కావాలి. సింగిల్ స్క్రీన్స్ అన్ని మల్టీ స్క్రీన్స్ లాగా కన్వర్ట్ చేయాలంటే దానికి గవర్నమెంట్ సైడ్ నుంచి ఎంకరేజ్మెంట్ కావాలి, చైనా గవర్నమెంట్ లాగా. ఇటువంటి కోరికలన్నీ రేపు 6th కాంక్లేవ్లో చేస్తున్నాం. అదృష్టవశాత్తు మాకేంటంటే భారత నీతి, అంతకుముందు ఫిక్కీ అసోచామ్ సిఐఏ వాళ్ళతో కలిసి మేము సెమినార్లు చేసాం, కానీ ఎక్కడా ఏ ప్రయోజనం మాకు దొరకలేదు, ఉపయోగం లేదు. వాళ్ళు మమ్మల్ని వాడుకున్నారు కానీ ఫిల్మ్ ఇండస్ట్రీకి అంటూ వాళ్ళు ఏమి చేయలే. ఎంటర్టైన్మెంట్ ఇండస్ట్రీ అని చెప్పి దానిలో టీవీ మీడియా, ఆడియో మీడియా, మ్యూజిక్, అలా కొన్ని డిపార్ట్మెంట్లను తీసుకున్నారు కానీ ఫిలిం ఫ్యూచర్ ఫిలిమ్స్ని పెద్ద కేర్ చేయలేదు. అందుకనే మాకు ఇప్పుడు లక్కీగా ఇది సెంట్రల్ గవర్నమెంట్ రికగ్నైజ్ చేసిన ఆర్గనైజేషన్ భారత నీతి, వారి ద్వారా ఒకేసారి 4 సెంట్రల్ మినిస్టర్సు, స్టేట్ డెప్యూటీ చీఫ్ మినిస్టర్ ఒకే వేదిక మీదకి తీసుకురావటం అనేది సౌత్ ఇండియన్ ఫిలిం ఛాంబర్కి, భారత నీతికి ఈ దొరికిన ఈ అవకాశాన్ని సౌత్ ఇండియన్ ఫిల్మ్ ఇండస్ట్రీ అంతా సద్వినియోగం చేసుకుంటారని చెప్పి ఆశిస్తూ సెలవు తీసుకుంటున్నాను.